member of a community, only if you know of the existence of human rights standards and of the existence of international rules on crimes against humanity, on genocide, on war crimes, then you can, as a responsible citizen, let's say, act within your national context to possibly make changes or have an influence. I'm not sure I answered your questions completely.
Yes, thank you.
Any other questions? Do we have questions here, guys?
I have the question to the second part of your presentation. I would like to ask, because I was speaking about the history, about the Germans, about what they did, the experiments. You were saying that each of us is with the privacy, the free choice and the human rights nowadays. But in the past, the Germans were making experiments. They were checking the genetic of the person, how they look like, if they go into the description. So I want to ask you, because nowadays we speak a lot about the abortions in Poland. Now it's a very important topic here, because in Poland now it's illegal, because even if the child is genetically modified, something is problematic, we have the, it has got the right to be born in Poland. We know that in France the abortion is like on the level of the human rights. How do you see it now in Italy, looking at the past and the history?
Thank you, because it is a very interesting question. In this moment, I think that we not have a problem about euthanasia as the T4 program. T4 program was a specific program. I can read the other point of my paper, because there was a specific decision signed by Hitler, and he decided to do a selection, a genetic selection. That is very important for us, because one man decided if you could life, or if you should kill. And well, what is the reason of this? The reason it was the idea of perfection. Perfection of human life. For work, or to do a good citizen. Good military for fight, a disability, the people that have some physician problems cannot fight. And so for him, they should be killed. The killing program is different about of contemporary, because now we have freedom. We have a freedom to choose, and we have the freedom to do a meditation about a good life. And I think that anyone can constrict me to choose. No, I'm free to choose if I want. And so the different situation is different in this moment. I think that there is a compare situation.
Professor Z was saying by going back to your question about abortion law. Let's frame it this way. There is clearly, as of today, no European consensus on whether or not there is a right to abortion, because this is what the European Court of Human Rights has said so far, I stress. And because there are cultural differences among the member states of the Council of Europe, and therefore different visions on the balance between the freedom of choice, which Professor Zidi was underlined, and the rights of the unborn child. Having said that, human rights are not fixed in time. They evolve with the evolving of societies, and I would say, thank God that they do evolve, because otherwise we would still be facing slavery as a rule of law. When it comes to reproductive rights and abortion, the situation in Italy is quite clear from a legal point of view, in the sense that according to our national law, it is possible for a woman to terminate, let's say, to ask for the termination of the pregnancy under certain conditions. And then those conditions are referring to basically the health of the woman, both physical health and mental health. So it is for the woman to decide within a certain time framework whether she wishes to continue the pregnancy or not. And for example, in the Italian legal system, a woman can decide freely, and I stress again, but in reference to what Francesco was saying, the relevance of a legal system recognizing freedom to choose, which is part of human dignity. Human dignity is about the possibility of making free choices, and the legal system should guarantee those freedom to make choices. Anyway, so under the Italian legal system, it is possible for a woman to terminate the pregnancy within a specific time frame if she believes that, for example, to have to become the mother of a seriously disabled child would represent a psychological burden for her to have it. So there is this possibility of terminating the pregnancy. In legal terms, what is unfortunately not working so well in Italy is the national health system providing this possibility. Because in Italy you have the large majority of medical personnel working in in obstetrician guards. They are because of their Catholic religion, they refuse to perform abortion, and they have the right to do so. Again, it's about freedom of choices. So if under, because of your religion, you do not want to perform an abortion to help a woman to terminate the pregnancy, then you can refuse it. And the problem is that nowadays for a woman in Italy, it might become difficult to find an hospital where to terminate the pregnancy because of the lack of medical staff consenting to this. You might be aware that there has been a decision of the European Court of Human Rights against Poland on an abortion case. Of a young girl, she was 15 years old, and she was raped. And as a consequence of the rape, she got pregnant, and she wanted to terminate the pregnancy, and which is one of the cases at the time recognized by Polish law as one of the possibility of termination of pregnancy when the pregnancy is the result of rape. It was very difficult for the girl to terminate the pregnancy. It was a huge